This is our combined worm count kit and lungworm kit. And today we're going to show you how to take your samples. So in the kit, you have your information and instruction leaflet. So you need to read that. It will show you how to take the sample properly. And inside, you're going to fill it in with your details. We have our four pots in our envelope, which you will need to put your samples back into. Check them out. There are four pots, three for lungworm and one for worm. And the worm will have a W on it. There's your return envelope, which you'll need, which is your trapped envelope back to the lab, and gloves for taking your samples. So, with all that's in there, what we say is, your lungworm test is a 3-day test. You have to take a sample on each consecutive day, and on the last day, you do your worm count. So on a Monday, a Tuesday, and a Wednesday, you're going to take a sample of your dog's poo. And on the Wednesday, the last day, we say do the worm count test as well from the same sample. This is because you need samples that are as fresh as possible. So, here's one we did earlier. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday sample, and on Wednesday you also do the lungworm. So now you've got your four samples. What we need you to do next is, again, the instructions are on the back. What we need you to do, and this is the very important thing, is the date, your name, the name of your dog, your address, your telephone number, and your email address. Your telephone number, your email address, your name, and your dog's name are crucial, because without that, we can't give you any information, because we won't know which dog it belongs to or who you are. We also need to know the age of the dog and if they have had any worming treatment. I've put here none, so the date doesn't apply, but you could be using Panacur, or you could be using something like Verm-X if you're using other things. So now, taking our sample bag, put the samples in. And there's a little moisture strip there in case anything leaks. Put that in, get rid of any excess air, peel off the tape, tape it, and press it down so it's sealed. So now you've got your samples and you've got your information. And all that now needs to go into this tracked envelope, which comes with your kit. This is the only envelope you need to use to send your kits to the lab in. This is because it's tracked. We can tell where it is. As long as you drop it off at a post office, they will give you a tracking number, then we know where it is. And it will go straight to the lab, and it's prepaid. Don't put this in anything else other than this envelope. So, here we are. You've got your envelope. Now what we need you to do is take the samples, the information, put them back in the box, close up the box, and put it in the bag. Seal the bag. You can put your contact details on there if you like. Put it in the post. Take it to the post office if you can and ask for proof of post. Then you can track it all the way. You'll know exactly where it is in the mail.